So you're a teacher now. Does that mean you're gonna start hanging out in the faculty lounge?
No, it means I don't have to sell cars all summer.
My brother, the professor.
My brother, the poet?
Now look, I'm only picking up that English credit because Coach forced me.
You chose poetry.
Well, of course I did. Poems are short.
Detour?
No, I'm cool. Figure how long can it be before she sees the light and comes crawling back.
I really need to talk to you, and it's serious.
You were out pretty early, weren't you?
Yeah, why?
The two of us have been up half the night, talking, thinking.
About?
Your mother. And the trouble she's in.
Look, forget about it. I have.
She's never come to us like this before.
Well, she's never been in jail before.
Look, nobody knows better than I do what a can of worms we could be opening up.
What?
If we took her in.
You're joking, right?
We're thinking it over, that's all.
How could you even... I'm sorry, this is none of my business, whatever.
It was one thing to refuse her financial help over the years. We've never had the money to give, even if we'd wanted to.
Which I didn't.
And you were dead right.
But to let your own flesh and blood stay behind bars, when you have the power to set her free.
It's your funeral.
Look, nothing's decided yet.
Well, listen, don't worry about me. And in fact, you can put her up here.
Come on now, Matt. You don't want her moving in with you.
No, I don't. She'd have the whole place to herself. I'm moving out tomorrow.
What's on your mind, Mel?
Well, I suppose you've heard about my sister and Daryl.
They left town together, I heard.
Have they been in touch yet?
No. And I was hoping... Well, I came to see if anybody had talked to either one of them before. Well, I was wondering if they'd said anything that might give us a clue as to where they've gone.
Sorry they didn't confide in me. I gotta get that answer sheet. I'll catch you later.
You got a problem with this simple fashion statement?
No, man, you got a problem like a major shiner under there. Courtesy of the lady Tina.
Says who?
You kidding? The whole school heard her when she found out you made a date with that blind chick. Then whammo, she emphasized her point.
Hey, can I help it if the woman is out of control over me?
Great. I need this. Spend the summer with Bozo.
Poor Pressfield. I'm not gonna take that personally because of where he's coming from. His lady dumped him for a biker.
Yeah, well, if your new lady saw what your face looked like, she'd run screaming.
Now, Tina, she can see real good. That's why she's been trying to make those improvements on your face.
Stifle it.
And if that's what she did to you for making the date, she's gonna break both your arms when you keep it.
What are you talking about?
You told that Laura babe you're gonna take her to Topper's today.
Did I say that? I forgot.
Are you telling me you're gonna stand her up?
No, I'm saying that I got a rotten memory.
Betcha she doesn't.
Well, be that as it might be, I'm also fast on my feet. I mean, how hard can it be to duck somebody?
There you are, Jojo.
How'd you know?
Your voice. It's very distinctive.
No kidding.
What'd you just ask me? Something about, is it hard to duck?
Do you want to disappear?
I'm ready when you are. I guess Daryl's the only one Stacy trusts now.
Well, at least she's not alone. That's lucky.
Look, you may not believe this, but I'm hurting for Billy, too. I mean, Matt and I both are.
Yeah, things happen. But still, the way it happened was...
It was awful, I know. But just when we were trying to find the best way to tell him, he found out. The wrong way. Worst way.
Whatever you and Matt were thinking, Billy is still pretty ticked. And you can't really blame him for that.
Oh, I don't. I just hope that he can get to the other side of this because he's hating me and I still really care about him a lot.
Stacy's home soon.
Yeah, me too.
How could I lose her?
I've been looking at ads for a while. I found a place this morning, and I put a deposit on it. As soon as I'm packed, I'm out.
Well, where is this place?
4th Street.
What I was afraid of. The worst neighborhood. It's not safe.
I know my way around.
Look, nobody said you had to rush. I mean, you could look around a little, find someplace better.
The deal was to be out when school's out, right?
Yeah, but it wasn't all that cut and dried.
Yeah, well, I think it's time.
Because of Basha?
Look, hold on a minute. For one thing, I told you, we haven't made up our minds yet about taking her in. I mean, it's a complicated decision.
Well, I'm one less complication.
But this whole counterfeit deal, I mean, as lousy as it was, it's like a warning to you. You're not gonna let her use you anymore.
Look, if warnings were any good, I'd have never helped her with the bag of money in the first place. Not after what she did last time.
Last time when?
Forget about it. It's not important.
Yeah, it is important. What else happened? I mean, she hasn't been around here making trouble. My God. The cross. It was Basha who took the cross, wasn't it?
It's okay as long as I stay mad. But when I see her, all I do is want her. After what she did, why should I care?
Feel what you feel, I guess.
Not if I decide not to. It hurts too damn much. I don't want it.
I know.
Did she say anything about me just now?
Well, she said that she still cares about you. A lot.
Right.
You know, not to justify what she did or anything, but the way she handled it,
the way she handled it stinks.
Yeah, I agree. I'm just saying that maybe there's a reason for that. You know, because, I mean, she's not mean or stupid. I think she just got messed up with all her family stuff. And look, her folks split, her sister's this horror show.
You think that I don't see her hurting? That's the worst part of this. I feel for her. You can't just turn that off, you know?
Well, maybe you shouldn't try.
I want to take her in my arms and hold her and tell her that everything's gonna be okay. That I'll be there for her no matter what. No, I can't comfort her anymore. Can't even help her anyway. That's gone now.
Are you sure?
What do you mean?
Okay, look, you can't put your arm around her. But there's no law that says you can't offer a helping hand.
No. Billy the helping hand. After everything Melinda's pulled, look, I may be soft in the head, but I'm no saint. To hell with it.
Okay, this is it, Toppers.
Great.
It's your standard nostalgia type of place. Lots of chrome tile, red, white, and black. Oh, that's dumb, huh? I mean, what do you know from red and stuff?
I remember red. This is where everyone hangs out?
Pretty much, yeah, yeah. Why?
It just doesn't seem like what I had in mind. It's so quiet.
Yeah, well, this is California, and people are a little bit more laid back.
Oh, I guess. School sounded pretty regular, though.
Well, here we are. Best table in the house. I tip the head waiter. Here, you can sit.
I mean, school. What do you hear? Everybody griping.
Right. But this place hardly seems alive. Is anybody here?
Oh, sure. Hey, Spider, what's shaking? Sally, nice threads. Hey, wait, we should wave back.
What'll it be?
Are you Lorraine? I've heard all about you.
Is two sodas okay?
The fountain's on the blink.
No kidding. When did that happen?
It must be a good 3 weeks.
Oh, how come I didn't know? Well, I guess I haven't been in here, you know, cramming for exams and everything. Got any juice or something?
Just coffee. Black.
Coffee's fine for me, thanks.
Make that too. This is some fun, huh?
Age 17. Mm-hmm. Weight 110 pounds. Height 5'6". Hair light brown. Eyes hazel. Yeah, and I want the "have you seen this girl" to be in 20-point boldface, all in caps. Right. Yeah, we'll start with 1,000. No, I'll pick it up myself. Thanks. Anything?
Well, everyone knows Stacy's gone, but no one knows anything else.
Oh, honey. I know this must be hell on you.
I wonder what it's like for Stacy.
We'll find your sister, Melinda, I promise. But this would all be a lot easier if we could support one another.
Yeah, well, I can imagine that could be true.
You think I'm bullying you about the Kubiak boy? I'm sorry.
If you were really sorry, you would stop doing it.
Melinda, I want you to try to understand something. I wasn't here to protect Stacy, so...
So now you're going to overprotect me?
I'm right about this, Melinda. I just wish you could see that.
Well, I'm too tired to see anything. I'm just gonna go take a nap.
Well, I think that sounds like an excellent idea. I'm just gonna get myself another cup of coffee.
She stole your cross. It had to be Basha.
You mean she was here and we didn't know it?
Well, she must have been, at least once. I mean, it's been how long since the cross disappeared?
It was toward the end of May when I missed it. But it was gone before Matt told us that much. Before Tom and Lizzie's wedding in April.
Why didn't I see it? The door's unlocked half the time. She just walked in and helped herself to the cross.
And when Matt gave it back...
Yeah, and there's my sister hanging around here with that Frankie character.
That's why you wouldn't tell us. Loyalty to your mother.
Well?
I've said all I've got to say about the cross.
Okay, okay. You don't have to say anything else. And you don't have to move out of here either.
I always knew you had good reasons.
Thanks. But I'm still planning to move out.
Matt? Oh, excuse me.
Linda?
Hello, dear. Have you had any news about your sister?
No. I just...
You want to visit Matt? That's fine.
The lawyer says we got a couple more days about Basha. You think things over,
We'll talk again.
See you later.
So anyway, we moved around a lot because of my dad's work. Detroit, Nashville, Chicago, Miami, New York, Brooklyn.
Wow, big city girl. No wonder West L puts you to sleep.
I didn't say that. I like Westdale already.
What's there to like? Anyhow, how much difference can it make to you? I mean, jeez.
It's okay. People say all kinds of dumb things to me. Hey, I didn't mean you were dumb. I just meant, like, uninformed.
So, inform me.
Of course I can tell the difference. Things smell different, they sound different. Same as people. I get a picture.
So you have a picture of me?
Of course I do.
Well?
Well, you know Tom Hanks?
Yeah!
Am I close?
You're very impressive. Actually, I do look a lot like Tom Hanks. Except people say that I have a little bit more...
More?
Hair.
Tom Hanks.
There's only one thing to remember.
What?
I don't know what Tom Hanks looks like either.
You know, I've never met anyone like you.
Oh, I'm not really that different.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Oh, and you're into Paradox.
Yeah, Paradox. What? Are you some kind of brain or something?
Do I look like a brain?
No way. You're really some kind of looker. I mean, looker as in...
Relax, Jojo. I know what you mean.
Yeah, you know what I mean. And maybe you and I ought to, get out of here.
Already? I wanted to try that famous jukebox. You said Topper's has the hottest one in town.
Oh, yeah. Maybe some other time. I gotta get those books.
No problem. And, one thing, Jojo. If we do go out again, why don't you take me to Topper's for real? Now that you know I won't dribble on myself.
How'd you figure it out?
My eyes don't work, but my brain's just fine, thanks. Shall we?
Oh, Billy, I'm glad to see you.
Thanks, Mr. Cox. Me too.
Come on in. Come in.
I didn't know about coming over, but I feel so bad about Stacy. I wondered if there's anything I could do to help.
That's very decent of you, Billy. As a matter of fact, I've just ordered some flyers that need to be distributed.
Oh, sure, no problem.
Can't have been easy to come over given Melinda's behavior.
No, I just came to talk to you, really, about Stacy. There's no point talking to Mel.
Well, I think you're wrong about that.
You do?
Well, the sooner you reopen channels, the faster she's likely to forget about Matt.
You really think she might?
If she's got a brain in her head, she will. And we know that Melinda is a bright girl. Melinda! You'll see. Work out. Linda!
She used you, Melinda. She knew that money was bogus, and she dragged you into this mess.
You know, even if she did know about the money, I'm sorry she got caught for your sake.
Your father's right. You have been corrupted.
My father is wrong. He's wrong, and he's wrong in about 10 different ways.
Hey, all right.
And he's worse than your mother. He's like a brick wall. At least she's not so damn sure she's right all the time.
No, Bobby's not into right or wrong.
And he's making me into this weird fugitive. I had to sneak out of my own house.
I'm glad you did.
I can't stay too much longer, but I had to come over here and see you. You're like the only right thing in my life.
Same here.
What is it with parents anyway? They love you and they make you miserable? And they screw up their own lives, so then they turn around and start in on yours.
Makes sense in a way.
How?
Well, the more trouble they give us, the closer we get.
Well, all I know is that being here, it feels right. And I feel safe. Where nobody can touch us.
What's wrong? Is she okay?
No, she's not there, but I know where she probably is.
Matt.
Yeah, they'll regret this. Both of them.
Stay tuned to Fox 25 at 7 for Maury Povich and the revealing A Current Affair. But right now, stick around for Hunter, Boston's best shot at 6 on Fox 25. Next.